Technology plays such a crucial role in today's schools. Having a network that's stable and is reliable and is not going to go down on them in the middle of the day is critical to their learning experience. So at Thunder Ridge, we installed the optical LAN for a number of reasons. One being that they have a brand new school, they wanted to be state of the art, and optical LAN is state of the art. Upgrades aren't a problem because you get single mode fiber. Theoretically, this building will never have to be recabled.
If they want to improve their connectivity or have better speeds, at a normal job where you had copper, you'd have to pull all the copper out and you'd have to put the newest stuff in.
Where there's no known bandwidth limitation with single mode fibers. If they want to go to 10 gig, change out a 10 gig ONT, and they're running to 10 gig. When 40 gig and 100 gig and beyond come out, it'll be a similar path. You change out a piece of equipment on both ends. You don't have to change out anything in the middle. This is a very different way to look at a network. So with the original design with a standard copper-based network, this school would have required multiple comm rooms.
I mean, this is truly amazing. 72 locations all being taken care of with this small of a bundle. Now, when you think about how big a copper bundle is, it's much larger than what we have here. This literally takes care of more than half of the third floor. And so it takes up a lot less space.
That's an advantage with starting a new school with this design in mind. So you have a certain amount of square footage that's dedicated space for that, communications rooms. When you can eliminate that, you can take that space and you can use that for other rooms. Whatever the school needs, they don't have to have that space just sitting there with network equipment on it. It can be repurposed for teaching students. Customers should understand that there's an option that takes them well beyond the 100 meter limitation of copper cabling. We have fiber that starts here at this OLT, and it runs all the way out to the far end of the building, even out to the press box at the football field and other places. And there is absolutely no active equipment between this room and the farthest network device, the ONT. The fiber doesn't really have a distance limitation, but the power does. At Thunder Ridge, we've installed a Alpha Systems DC power plant. The advantage is a centralized location, so if the power does go out, that the system continues to run. For that new middle school, they won't have to plan for TRs. They'll need some space for some fiber splitters if they want to do the DC power plant again for the ONTs, but there won't be a requirement for racks, switch gear, all that kind of stuff. That'll all be taken out of this building. So it adds to the operational efficiency of the network. It's a much simpler system to install and to manage than a standard network. They open up one window on their computer, they're able to see the entire network and drill down to every single port and see exactly what's going on. They're able to control what devices can connect to it. It's a really powerful system on that end to administer the network. So with Optical LAN and Tellabs, we're able to give customers a solution that meets needs that they can't really meet in a good way otherwise.